4 million babies are born in the U.S. every year. The majority come into the world with no apparent health concerns, but sometimes looks can be deceiving.
Tonight, medical specialist Christy Krueger shares the story of one child born to someone within our own Local 10 family who was blindsided by a surprising diagnosis.
Firefighters face another uphill battle. Zimmerman was accused of sending threatening messages.
When J.C. Birch took her first job in television news nearly two decades ago,
first on 10, a driver.
She was laser-focused on her career.
I never, ever thought I was maternal or would want to have children.
That all changed in 2015.
Then there just comes a certain time and you think, oh my gosh, I don't know if my life would be fulfilled without a child. And so I definitely took that plunge.
JC's pregnancy was uneventful until September 2016. 1 week before her due date, JC was involved in a serious car accident.
But all I care about is the baby okay? Is the baby okay?
JC's unborn baby was alive and well, but an ultrasound technician saw something of concern.
She says, I don't know. I think we're gonna have to do a renal ultrasound when you give birth. And I'm kind of like, what does that mean? What are you talking about?
Shortly after giving birth, doctors told her Jupiter had only one functioning kidney.
And I was just a mess. I was just crying my eyes out.
Little Ray here is a perfectly healthy newborn baby girl, but one out of every 1,000 babies are born every year with only one functioning kidney. And some of those babies will grow up to be adults and it never gets detected.
35-year-old Andrew Linhares only found out after his doctor ordered an ultrasound to check for other concerns.
It was weird, shocking. I'm still shocked. It makes me a little nervous, especially as I get older.
Andrew was put on blood pressure medication as a precaution. High blood pressure can cause damage to the kidneys, and so can some common over-the-counter medications like ibuprofen.
I warn parents to always tell doctors when they're gonna give medication, to let them know that they have one kidney. So we are a little more careful with nephrotoxic drugs.
Dr. Felix Ramirez with Nicklaus Children's Hospital says advancements in imaging do make Jupiter's case unusual.
You can begin seeing kidney tissue prenatally at around 10 to 12 weeks of gestation. But then by 20, 25 weeks, you can identify clearly not only if the kidney's there, but you can tell if the kidney is actually normal because you see more details.
No one knows exactly why earlier ultrasounds didn't pick up on Jupiter's missing kidney.
Ready?
Which JC now says makes that car accident a blessing in disguise.
At least I know what I'm dealing with it with Jupiter and what I can do to help him. So I'd rather know than not know.
I'm Christy Krueger, Local 10 News.
So what does the future hold for babies born with one functioning kidney? Well, for the most part, they should experience a normal life. However, these children do need to be especially careful about diet. Obesity can be a key trigger for kidney disease, and some high impact activities could expose them to kidney injury.